guys. I'm Courtney. I'm the singer for Iwrestledabearonce, and we're here in Serbia with you. Is it on? Okay. All right. So before I was in Iwrestledabearonce, I was in a band, and we were called Unicron. And the band was myself and my boyfriend and my little brother. And we were a band for a very long time. So basically, whatever my brother wrote, I would have to learn to sing over. So when he started writing heavier stuff, then I, of course, had to start singing heavier and listening to heavier music. When I was a little kid, I always went to church with my parents. And in church, I always loved the part where I could sing, whenever there was the singing. So later on, when I got a little older, I joined the church band, and I kind of realized that I didn't really care about being in church. I just really liked being up in front of everybody and being the singer in the band. So that really got me into like performing. And of course, you know, I think the thing that set it off was probably when I was really little and all the Disney movies, all the singing parts in the Disney movies. I would sit there when I was like 2 years old and I would act out every part of every movie and sing every part of every movie. So I think when I was younger, I just realized that I was basically always like, look at me, look at me. And so that's how I knew. That's how all singers know. They want everyone to look at them all the time. And then they know they want to be a singer. The best thing about being on tour is meeting new people, going to new places, getting to see places for free. You get to travel all over the world, and you don't have to pay a single dime. That's amazing. Getting to play in new places. But the worst thing about being on tour is, of course, you know, missing your family and your boyfriend or your girlfriend, and missing, you know, I'm missing my stepdad's retirement and like stuff, like little things like that. So, but it's a lot easier nowadays because you can go on Skype, you can FaceTime, and you can see everybody. But that's everyone's hardest thing, is being able to keep in touch with their family. Well, I've been very, very fortunate to get to play a few tours with Every Time I Die, and they're one of my favorite bands. So they're like, I couldn't believe it that I got to become friends with them and watch them every single night. I would watch them play, no matter how many I saw them. I guess I've probably seen them play, I guess maybe at least 30 times I've seen them play. So no matter what, even though I've watched the same show over and over for maybe 40 times, I still every night watch them. So that's been my favorite so far. Well, us in Texas in July, we have the same management, and so Royal Division Entertainment. So we really wanted to come to Europe this summer, and we needed friends that also wanted to come and wanted to pay for a bus and go all over Europe with us. And we were having trouble. We were like, who are we gonna have? Because they have to be, number one, really nice, number two, be a really good band, and number three, want to live on a bus with us for 6 weeks. So we found Texas in July, but we needed a third band. And then along came our saviors in VITJA, because if they weren't on there, then if they weren't on the bus with us, then we probably would have just taken vans, the two vans, it's cheaper. And so they are our saviors. So we all three of bands, we all live on a bus together, and we all have very different music from each other, but We all somehow get along very well, and I think our music, our concert goes, it flows very well. This is a long one. Okay, so it is hard sometimes to be a girl in a band because you're the only one usually, and so you don't have like someone who can identify with you and understand, you know, that maybe I need different things than the guys, or so, you know, whether it's just that, you know, I need somewhere private that I can change my clothes, or you know, just little things. But I think the reason that girls don't want to be in bands, there's not very many, is any girl would agree with me. I think no matter where they grew up, no matter if they're in Serbia or if they're in the United States, we have a different way that we grew up than boys. Boys are taught, yes, be dominant, speak up in class, speak your mind, and you want people to look at you. Girl, we have an opposite way that we grew up. It's be quiet, be humble, be docile, be submissive. Those are the opposite of what you have to be a performer. Whether it's an actor, or to be a CEO of a company, to lead, you know, to be a leader in a band, you have to be a leader. And I think that it's harder for a girl. We have singers we look up to, but being a singer, being like Rihanna or Beyonce, it's different than being in a band, because a band is like a group of friends. So we don't have a lot to look. There's not a lot of women that like I got to look at when I was little, when I was young, that inspired me. It was men. It was like John Mayer and like the Foo Fighters and like those guys, Coldplay, like those guys. There was not a lot of girls that I would get to watch and say, oh, they're a part of that group. They're in a band.
What's up,
band.
What's up,
I'm
dude?
Band with Courtney.
You know, we here, we out here, we reppin' in Serbia. You know what it is.
So anyway, I think that's why. It's a long, complicated thing. It's not the guy's fault. It's not other band's fault. It's not management's fault. It's just like a lot of us just didn't know that we would be allowed to like to be in a group of guys and say, you're one of us, come in the band. Or other girls to play music, play guitar, play drums. And that's what I love to see a band with girls who aren't just famous because, oh, they're girls. They're famous because they're really good musicians. And I love that. I love that so much. That's what I want. I want people not to say, oh, she's really good for a girl and she has very pretty hair. But I want people to say, she's just really good, like, period, good. That's what all girls want. It's like people to say, you're good. Beyonce. I love her. It's funny, I think a lot of people probably think that people that are in metal bands that we don't listen to any music but metal music. But I will be honest, I don't really know in the scene that we are in. So we're different than like, you know, big metal festival, like the dudes with like the big spikes and the long hair. It's a little bit different music we play. It's a little different. Like us in Texas in July, we're just kind of different than like Slayer or something like that. You know, it's just a little different. And so I don't know, I can't speak for those guys. But I can speak for like bands that I would call like Warp Tour bands. None of us really like to listen to metal on our off time because that's all we hear all night. 5 hours of metal every night. And then what we do when we go home, we write metal music. So when we're driving around and working out or walking around, we like listening to the opposite. So most guys are always listening to hip hop or pop music or anything other than metal, because we need to cleanse our head, right? We need to like reset and not listen to that. Get it out. So yeah, Beyonce is the greatest performer and singer of all time, and I love her. And someday I hope to meet her, and I'll cry. Yeah, it does bother me. It's because I feel like with Facebook and Instagram and all that, kids feel like they know us, like they know everything that goes on in our lives, but they don't know anything about us. So it's like, I never thought about it that way, but when someone leaves a band and you're mad, to you all I say, just suck it up. If you love them so much, don't listen to the new music, and you have all the old CDs, they're always there. But that's why it's hard. I feel like, you know, 10 years ago, it wouldn't have been that big of a deal. But nowadays, it makes people sad because they feel like they're losing somebody that they really care about, right? So I totally understand. I'm the same way, right? Because I'm a fan of bands. If someone left the band, like the band Tesseract, their singer just left, and they have a different singer now, and I'm like, oh, I miss that guy. But I'm like, wait a second. No, you don't. I don't know what's going on in the band. I don't know why he quit, why they're not together. So yeah, it gets annoying, but I totally understand, because I would be exactly the same way. But I think bottom line is, like, all of us girls, the old singer and all the other girls, we all have to stick together. Or Arch Enemy, they're having a new singer. I know that's hard, but we can't hate each other, because there's not very many of us and we all have to stick together. So we all respect each other, and like, we all want all the other girls to succeed. We don't want one to do better than the other. We all want everyone to succeed, because there's not a lot of us, so we all need to. Oh my God, I don't know. It always changes, because we wrote a new album last year, so those are all my favorites. And I sing a lot in them, like more of normal singing. And then now, for some reason, I really like doing the older songs that don't have a lot of singing. So I think what that means is now I want to do heavier, like make heavier music with more screaming in it. But I think that my favorite, I'm trying to think, I mean, obviously the song Tastes Like Kevin Bacon, because that's a song that a lot of people really, they know of our band. So it makes me really excited, because I see that we play the first note and everyone freaks out. They're very excited, so that one always has to be my favorite. But I really like singing the song Fire Beats, because I get to dance around, and there's a part that's very pretty and then a part that's very scary and loud. So I like going from quiet to really loud. So I guess Fire Bees is my perfect song to sing. That and Tastes Like Kevin Bacon. I do. There's sometimes in songs, once the guitar players will present like a finished song to me, I'm like, oh my God, this is gonna be like the part where everyone would say, move to the side, and everyone goes. But I don't think about that a lot when I'm writing songs. I just think about writing a song, like writing a story, a poem. And then, you know what? A lot of our songs are kind of hard to follow. And so people might not know that maybe now's the time to like start moshing, or now's the time to start two-stepping, or whatever. But that's okay, because, you know, we write what we write. And some bands are easier to follow and more like predictable. And I mean that in a good way, because then you can like get into the flow of the song. And some bands are more like us, where sometimes you can get into the flow, but a lot of the time you're just waiting, like, what's gonna happen? So I think it's good to have a bit of both, like predictability, and then also, you know, throw them, as we say, a curveball. They don't know what's gonna happen. So I always envision, like, this is the part. This is the part where everyone's gonna go, yeah! Or sing along with me. That's what I always want. Well, it's time to say goodbye. It's time for me to get on that bus and read Game of Thrones, wash my face and brush my teeth, and take off these filthy clothes that are covered in sweat from the last 2 weeks of tour. And thank you all for listening to me. I'm sorry. I apologize that I'm covered in bodily fluids and who knows what else, and I'm sorry that I sound like an old woman, but this is what happens when you go on tour and you don't take care of your voice. You sound like an old lady. I don't even smoke, I swear. So thank you so much, and I hope to see everybody at our next show. We'll be back very soon. I sincerely hope that. Thank you.